DevTech Media. Subscribe to DevTech Media. DevTech Media. Subscribe to DevTech Media. DevTech Media. Subscribe to DevTech Media. DevTech Media. Subscribe to DevTech Media.
Nika strategy chapi. Nika strategy mwana. Joseph Lungu. Right? Behind the scenes, a lot of people work, but the general membership is not aware because there are backroom people doing a lot of work and they must never be left behind. So, Godfrey Bene, right? We promise that we are a rainbow nation. So, Suresh Desai. We promise we're a rainbow nation, right? Dr. Chulwe Beani, Mr. Shaputu from the Copper Belt, and who else here? Rainbow Nation, Costa Morianos Mwape. Rainbow Nation. Who else? Just to be sure that we've got it right. Axon Sejani. Right. Rainbow Nation continues. Our colleague Kurie. Different value comes on the table. If you know these names, you understand what each one of them brings to the table, which you may not be able to bring yourself, but someone else brings it, then that's the way we work. Lastly, but not the least, I know you'll be very happy, Dr. Guy Scott. I was with him a couple of days away. He's got a very strong brain, so he comes through. So that's the 14. So Major Folosh, Sajan, Sydney Sanga, Mono, Mapani, Vene, Mulondwe Mzungu, Costa, Mwape, Chulwe Beani, Ephraim Belem, I hadn't mentioned him, Ephraim Belem, Grizzle Shaputo, Joseph Lungu, Mr. Kulie, Suresh Desai, Dr. Guy Scott. That's the 14. You have heard them, isn't it? Very good. Very nice. Yeah, let's go to the remaining chairs, rows, portfolios. Grace Chiwa. I know Grace is surprised because you are mentioned twice. Don't worry about that. The other things are administrative. So Grace Chiwa, you take the chair for rural development, madam, because you grew up in the village like me. So you're the chair. So the other little issues are administrative, right? Percy Chanda. Some of you know our gallant Percy Chanda, our chairman Mines. Joseph Mpuka, last time I told you about the importance of that corner of our country. In the Luangwa section, Feira, which is normally forgotten, we have made up our minds. No one will be forgotten. Joseph Mpuka takes the chair, chair cooperatives. Chulwe Beani, chair education. Right? John Mumpansha Chinyanta is chairman technical education, educational trainer. Right? Ambrose Rufuma. Hopefully, you will serve us well as chairman planning. That's his specialism. Joseph Lungu, this good Lungu, the good Lungu, is chairman research. Chairman research, Joseph Lungu. Credo Nanjua, chairman livestock. Godric Chewe, chairman water development. Daniel Chisala. Chairman Fisheries, deliberately because of the Ruapula program we have there. the water bodies in Wapula and all of those places. Let's see how our brother there can gel in with our program of teaching people how to fish rather than giving them one piece of fish in a corrupt way. Different thinking. So I was talking of Daniel Chisala, Bob Sakahilu, Chairman Health, right? Sydney Chisanga. Sydney is Chairman Transport. We all know Sydney, what he does. But Frank Tayari, Chairman Governance. Very important. We brought in new roles here. Chairman Governance will deal with the rule of law, making sure that we have a rule of law. Human rights are respected. Media rights are respected. Media. He's a lawyer and he's a buddy. You can see how he pushes, right? Making sure that Anti-Corruption Commission is working, Drug Enforcement, Financial Intelligence Center, making sure that the Auditor General is working well, Separation of Powers, Parliament, Legislature, that is Parliament, Legislature, Executive, which is overbearing, is monitored, as well as, obviously, the importance of, if I may say, what we've been seeing happening in the judiciary. Very, very important to make sure that these three arms of government, plus the media I talked about already, is given space. Each one of them is given dedicated space to do what they need to do for their people. Douglas Sekalima will continue working with the president as advisor. Right. George Sinkala, housing. Clarissa Chikamba, gender, Vene, labor. This chap was a unionist, this colleague was a unionist, right? This colleague, right? I replaced the word chap. I've learned to be very sensitive on the words I use. Because last press conference, I'm told someone was angry because I joked around that individual. So I'm very, very careful so I withdraw that. This gentleman. So, Felix Ngoma, communication, right? Mono Mapani, social security. Elijah Muchima, homeland security. And Prudence Chinama, youth and sports. Salome Mwanakatwe, child and nutrition. Helen Mulenga, Banda, entrepreneurship. Ephraim Belem, environment and natural resources. Don't confuse the twice naming, because first you come through, for some people, into the NMC, then you're wrong. Please, let's not say there was double counting. There's no double counting there. I said Salome Mwanakatwe, Helen Mulenga, Ephraim Belem, environment, Romeo Kangombe, to the deputy strategy and mobilization, right? We want to bring the youth there, a lot of youth. Mutinta Mazoka, deputy planning. Isaac Mukuka, deputy education. Simbea Jairo, deputy cooperative. Teta Mashimba, deputy youth and sports. Again, young people. Chikota Steven, deputy national youth chairman. Chikota Steven. Trevor Mwinde, the last deputy national youth chairman. Completes the youth. We want vibrance in the youth. Took a lot of time there to look for vibrance, fearlessness. You know, not just, as I said last time, one blank is blown, the youth are running away from polling stations. Not this time. Not August. No one leaves a polling station. No one leaves a polling station. No one leaves the polling station. Because that's what the Mwankoles are banking on. That they will come into a polling station, create disturbance, and will run away. No one runs away from the polling station. If you want to run away from the polling stations, don't go in the polling station. Stay at home. Ngare kunyumba, amama akayende mu polling station, wamanga chitenge mweo mukasunge vana panyumba. Sima sobera. Time for change. Siku kamba kamba. I'm even wasting time talking here. It's time for change. It's time for what?
Change.
12 August. It's time for change. So polling stations shall be manned. I think you heard. We NMC leaders here, do not push your nephew who is 12 years to be in the polling station. It will not be allowed. It will not be allowed. The youth movement will be the source of polling agents, largely. Let me hear me out. The youth movement working with the women movement. These will be the main people to give us polling agents. And they must know their people. They know that Chikoti will not run away. They know that Mwinde won't run away. They know that Lisoliso will not run away. They know. So there will be, hear me out, there will be no squeezing. Whether you are NMC, you are a president, you call yourself president of UPND, or vice president, or a deputy secretary general, or indeed you are a candidate. Let me be very clear. You push your nephew to go in the polling station. You are a provincial leader, constituent chairman, just for the little money. 12 August is not for that allowance. It's to deliver this country. Munakumbo mane? Brian Ndumba, deputy elections. Tambita, deputy technology. I told you we want to use technology effectively, starting with our in-house work here, to deliver services, to deliver support arrangements. Fraser Monde, deputy chair, rural, to work with Grace. Simbe Jairo. No. Okay, right. Cooperative Deputy Harrison Piri, Apiri, Deputy Chair Livestock, Elena Sakala, Deputy Chairperson Community, Chile Shekangwa, Deputy Chair Arts, because he's a performer, he can help us in that area. Griza, Deputy Chair Treasurer, Deputy Treasurer General, Brigadier General Geshom Chung, Deputy Homeland Security, to work with Muchima. They know each other. They know what they do. I don't know what they do, but they know what they do. Is that offensive, what I've said? Kenneth Ngona, Deputy Chair Youth. Miuna Katolo, Deputy Chair Legal and Constitutional. Mulambo Haimbe, Deputy Chair Legal and Constitutional. The legal team is really being brought together. Remember, the first deputy was Daphne, our lawyer from the Copper Belt. Daphne Chavu, our lawyer from the Copper Belt. And then we have a legion of trustees. Just to mention, the legion of trustees is Shuresh Desai, Nathan Ilunga. We never forget friends. We should have a space for old friends, new friends, young future friends. That's how an organization works. I know people are saying, why are the former provincial chairman coming through here? You need the heritage. For the new chairman, they must know where they're coming from when you take over. Otherwise, you start exercising people out. People come, 20 people come in, 20 people go out. How many people do you have? Zero base. Same situation. This part respects that. I know where I'm coming from. I was just an ordinary member when I became president, when Mr. Mwava made me president and his colleagues through the election. I know where I'm coming from. I have been in this party from day zero. And the only way we've grown this party from 27% of the national vote to where we are now is by keeping the old,
bringing in new ones, continuing to recruit. That's the only formula. You give me any other formula, I'll take it, if it's a better formula. I don't know any other formula. So there is space for everybody. I'm repeating. All of a sudden, UPND members are shouting, Luini Lekale, Luini Lekale. Where have you won Kale Kale? Right? This is the time to bring more members. I'm following what's happening. Tinilabongwe want to bring members, board members are resisting. Please come on. Please, understand what we want. What we want is to win and win big. One, which means we need to recruit, which means we must accommodate people, which means that even old members must stay. Where you are coming from, where you are today, where you are going is very important. I come from the background of running business. It's the same principle. Those are the principles I'm applying here. And that's why the party has grown. So if you came in, you want to shut the door, you don't want others to come in, do you want to win an election?
No.
So can we change our mindset? Too much saying, I am this. If we don't form government, what's the value of your kapuna? I'm asking a question. Is there anyone courageous enough to answer me? I'm asking a question. The mindset of you leaders seated here, if I'm talking to a person from Northern Province, why should I, hear me out there, this is serious. My friends there, Zambia, hear me out, this is serious. If I'm talking to somebody from Northern, to recruit someone from Northern, why do I need permission to talk to the Vice President? Because she's from the Northern. Why? Why do I need her permission? This has been going on here. I'm listening. I'm watching. I said, what is this behavior? What is this behavior? You want to recruit someone from where I was born in Wengwa Ward, Wengwa constituents, where I was born. Go ahead and recruit them. You don't need my permission because you may know them better than me. Maybe me at the cattle post we fought when we were young. So they will not come through me, they will come through you. I'll be very happy if you did that. I'm serious, I'm not joking. There is no one who needs to be consulted to recruit new members. There's no one. You don't have to consult me. You're doing something good for this party, go ahead and do it. Right? Please. Ndee lomba. Na mikupa wanawayesu. I am picking this behavior. No, afuna tipoke chito tangena kare. Who tiwangena? Tika menyewa mpoding station, you need that one, the one you don't want to come. You need him to help you. Yes. Ten tingene mkati moja. Neba waku mkanyama is not yet with us. Go out to them. We are skilled differently. Some of us, where we grew up, we don't know something called fear. That's why you hear they're coming to my house, 300 policemen. Everyone tells me, run away. I said, where? This is my house. Whoever wants me finds me there. I never run away. But that's how I was brought up. Go to my home. That's how we live there. We don't know fear. So you need people who are fearless, but you also need some people with certain shrewdness to do what I can't do. Combined, we succeed. I have deliberately spent time here because when we brought in Nathan Ilunga, colleagues, some colleagues from Northern were complaining. VP, manage those people. Where you fail, ask Bamwaba. He will help us manage those people. You haven't brought an MP there. We are recruiting people. You start complaining. Now we mulongwa na. Kabarete we want to bang MP uliatu ya MP. Serious. It doesn't, I've only used Northern to sort of abuse them. It applies everywhere. That's why I use my birthplace. It applies everywhere. So, I was talking about the Legion of Trustees. I said Shures Desai, Nathan Ilunga,
Matambo Samantha, Vamwaba Christopher, this man is knows this party inside out. He knows this party inside out. We want to consult about UPND, go to Mr. Mwaba. Go to him. That's why a trustee is a very important role. Very, very important. It's not a demotion as some people think. Mwape, Costa. Huyu mtu ni mzungu ka? He's Mwape, but ni mzungu, eh? In case some of you don't know him. Paul Tole. That's another area where noise was coming. Tole was there when no one wanted to join UPND in the Eastern Province. Tole was there. So why should you complain? What role has he taken of yours? Just create your own role. Please. That's the way we grow. In my young days in business, I was very aggressive. I got rid of a Muzungu supervisor because he was lazy. I just made him redundant. The rest is history. You can do the same. Make me redundant. Then I'll be happy the party will have grown. That's another name I'm bringing, Paul Sichamba. Why Sichamba? Yes. When I went to Isoka, the party was not popular. 2-3 people received me at the door, at the entrance of Isoka. Sichamba was there. Why should we have no space today? Because we have grown. I want to know. What's the logic? So can you clap for Paul Sichamba, Nathalie Lunga? Bamwaba is a veteran, yes, but deliberately clap for also a guy called, who was mentioned last time, Njamba Musang. You clap for him as well. Even there in Western, there was noise about Njamba. How much more space do you want for yourself? Why do you want to deny others a space? We need each other, right? So, Kulie, I've mentioned already, our brother Kulie, and the chief consultant, when we feel like we can go there, is Dr. Guy Scott. That's our chief consultant. There's a lot we can learn from him. I am learning a lot from him. And we must learn to respect each other in this community. That man was actually a Republican president. He served as a Republican president. And in our time, we have a way of looking after such people. After August, those who saved the country. And they will represent those that have left us, in a way. There is some administrative work we are going to do, because the last announcement is the Secretary General, who is Honorable Batuke Mende, is the new Secretary General. So there is some administrative work we are going to do around this, which is normal. The administrative work is normal because there will be an overlap like herself, like Grace, and one or two other people. Thank you. The key thing here for us members of this party is that we should know where we are coming from, we should know where we are, we should know where we are going. Heritage, where we are coming from, where we are, where we are going. But there's room for everybody. If you don't work on this principle, you will never even run a successful tomato garden. You must work on this principle. Where are you coming from? Where you are? Where you are going? Then you can run a successful chicken run. Then you can run anything else. Recognize the skills around you, the diversity of skills, the differences people carry with them, because that's how God made us. We are all talented differently. But when we pull each other's talent together, we will be able to deliver this country.
Let's focus on delivering elections. Let's focus on winning. That's how we will look after the orphans. That's how we will look after the differently abled. That's how we will look after the women in the market. That is my request. So I say to you, small administrative issues will come. Don't worry about that. We are aware of one or two overlaps, like in Grace's case and in somebody else's, but that's behind the scene. Let us get on with the work. I must also say, you don't have to like somebody to work with them. I learned this as a young professional myself, in the professional hall. Because we had whites, we had Indians, as a young graduate, we had ethnicity, diversity. Zambia?
Four.
Zambia?
Four.
Zambia, Mwinda and your group. Mwinda and your group, pay attention. Zambia?
Four.
Yes. Zambia?
Four.
I learned this art as a young professional. That you don't have to love somebody you work with. Because there are two different people with two different characteristics. What is important is the common interest. That's all. You will be fine. When you respect other people, they may have habits that you don't like. If the habits are not destroying the common interest, you'll be fine. You will succeed. But one of our agendas as a party is to reunite this country. To reunite this country means we have to work unity in diversity. If we don't do that, we'll be falling in the PF trap, where cabinet comes from four provinces only. We've already committed that the UPND cabinet will come from all the provinces of Zambia. I think you have seen it here. All the provinces of Zambia. Because they are skilled people, they are educated people from all the 10 provinces of Zambia. No one can tell you and I that some provinces have no educated people. No. It means you are being divisive. Remember our theme for the General Assembly. One was to reunite the country. Two was to rebuild, reconstruct our country. That's it. So with these changes, don't stop coming to the Secretariat because there are different personalities there. Continue coming. Come even more. Come even more. If you fail to accommodate other people, then you are in the wrong place. You are in the wrong country. God gave us 73, 72 ethnic groups. Is God a fool? How can God be a fool? He knows. He wanted us to work together. We practice it in this party, then you see it in government. Charity begins at home. Charity begins where?
Home.
I think I have spoken. This team, I did say there will be a bit of administrative work. One or two people, don't worry. There's a little bit of moving here, there, to make sure that there's no distortion and there's no over-concentration of people in one component or area. So that's what took us time. I know you would have loved it to have been done quickly. It wasn't. I think 1 month is a good time. Very good time to do a decent piece of work, which PF has failed to do in 10 years. PF has failed to bring this country together in 10 years. We have walked a giant step ourselves in 30 days, in 1 month, to be able to do this. So, depends on how you work. Certainly, this is how we would like to work ourselves. Outside of these roles, there will be a lot of specialized committees. For example, technology, to support the colleagues in the leadership on technology, the economic team, where Joseph Lung is aware, he has a broad team working with him inside and outside the country. Zambian people, I'm not talking about foreigners, offering themselves a free service. I just wanted to make that clear, that behind these roles, there will be a lot of colleagues. There are already a lot of colleagues doing a lot of work so that we can close the gaps where there are gaps, so that we can learn from each other, those who had the exposure, those who have been living outside the country and are able to add value, we would like, and we have already been consulting them to add value. You will see when we announce our manifesto very soon, it has been well thought through. And you'll be very pleased. Because there's a lot of work behind that. And not everybody, us here seated, are able to do certain things. As the Vice President said, the choir is very important. The choir is very important. The youth are very important. The women are very important. Very important. Everybody's important. That's the way I learned the art of small business at a young age. To learn how important your client is, how important your supplier is. To learn how important it is to deliver the service, quality service. Then you continue making money. We must learn how to deliver this country. Start with us. I'm buttressing things that are behind the scenes. We have a lot of good doctors who have agreed to serve in the health committee. But for many reasons, they cannot take the chairship. You know what's going on. Immediately they will be removed from their ward. Even if patients will die there, someone will remove the doctor because they're associated with us. But they've agreed to do a lot of work. Teachers, in terms of retired teachers, retired professions in many ways, we are bringing Zambia together. Zambia United is our theme. Then we can win, win big, protective world, rebuild this country. Endi tamkwa. Mboji bebe. Lastly, just to indicate that I have a duty not to forget our mine friends on the Copper Belt. Last time we spoke here, we did ask this PF and the liquidator of KCM to pay the packages, benefits, redundancy packages for the miners who have been declared redundant. The PF have been saying they will pay, they have not paid. And I'm talking to our colleagues on the mining side there on the Copper Belt, they have not been paid. After many promises, the PF is hiding behind court matters. And that's, they are saying why they are not paying workers. Courts can take 2, 3 years, 5 years. The workers cannot wait for 5 years. Pay the workers immediately. PF, if you are hearing, you have been throwing money all over. You are sleeping on cash. I believe maybe printed cash. Pay the mine workers who have been declared redundant now. They've told them they'll pay them on the 31st. Woofy. You love eating what is not yours. Find the money to pay the miners. And the full packages. Don't pay them half, quarter. Pay them the full packages. That's our message. Secondly, you have been saying you will increase their salaries and you are hiding behind. Who is hiding behind? The PF. Behind the restructuring program. The restructuring program should not delay this improvement of remuneration for workers. That's an excuse. The prices are increasing every day. Bread, wunga, Pamela, yes, Pamela Mzanga, carpenter. So, the prices are not waiting for restructuring. Pay increased packages to the workers in the KCM. You promised. Don't hide behind restructuring. Now, Mumfwa, you have a head. Don't pretend you haven't heard. You have a head. Pay. The money is there. Where are you getting the money you're throwing all over? You're playing with. We have never seen a country degenerate to this level where you can play, you know, with mountain of cash. When the treasury is empty, individuals who have no track record in business are playing with cash. It's only true that they're stealing the money. But use that money, give it to the owners, pay the workers. I think that's our message. I sit down by saying, can we stop the speculation of who is going to be what?
let us get into a field. Polling stations. That's where we are all going. Polling stations. You big burners appointed here, we want to see each other at the polling stations. Let us go to the polling stations. Let us cover the country. I want to thank the youth, what you did on Youth Day across the country. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. The NMC must learn from the youth. You see how the world works. The NMC must learn from the youth. The youth were all over. And I want to express my displeasure why our youth who were marching peacefully were attacked and arrested. When the PF had gathered somewhere around, no one attacked them. I want to ask the police inspector general, please, you swore to work professionally and to protect citizens, not to attack citizens. You attack people, then you turn around, you say, UPND has attacked the police. We were all watching what happened there. The police attacked harmless and armless people. There are a lot of good policemen in our uniform, but we have a few PF cadres wearing police uniform. Inspector General, protect every citizen. And I want to assure the people of Zambia, after 12th of August, you are sworn in the morning, we are sworn in the morning. By afternoon, one of our major pronouncements is law and order. There will be law and order. There will be law and order. No woman, no mother, no sister, no auntie will be beaten in a market by thugs and those thugs get away with it. No, zero. Zero. No one will be beaten at the bus stop. Intercity there, you go there, you get beaten for wearing a UPND t-shirt. Nothing of that nature. There will be law and order. So people can move freely within the country, freedom of movement. They can dress the way they want. They can trade and do business the way they want. Their stores are safe in the market. Wherever they are trading, we will support you. We will not beat you or allow anyone to beat you or indeed take away your business opportunity. We will actually enhance your business opportunity. I talked about last time, those 9 points. Please don't forget what we say, 9 points. We gave you the 9 points of what we're going to do. One of it was to give credit support, support for money to our traders, women, youth, everybody. Mwilavayo. I know someone says Zambians have short memories. I know you can, we will help you grow the memory because by being consistent, we will help you grow the memory. You have the memory, but you have been abused by wrong leadership of the PF. God bless you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr.